The basement dungeons are dark, humid, and foul, unfit for life of any kind, filled with maniacs who raved and howled like tortured beasts for want of light and air and food and ordinary human associations and habiliments. That was from an 1870 report on conditions at the Indiana State Hospital for the Insane, given to the governor by the hospital superintendent. Originally opened in 1848, this was once a sprawling complex of buildings dedicated to housing and treating those with chronic mental illness. Seemingly progressive in its treatments, and at the same time plagued by reports of rampant patient abuse, forced sterilizations, and questionable deaths. The hospital was shut down in 1994, and since then, most of the buildings have either been demolished or repurposed. The asylum's power plant, however, still remains intact.
We'll go down there in a minute. Little of this, little of that.
Do you hear that noise? Somebody hitting on a pipe.
Inches water over fire. Oh, there's a furnace. See the brick, this brick thing?
Mm-hmm.
That was the furnace. I wonder what. I wonder what it must have been like to work in here.
Scary, hot.
Hot, loud,
dusty.
Dangerous, yeah. Yeah. Really hope these don't fall. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Are you sure? Don't step on that. There's a room up there. Glad we didn't have a heavy breakfast. Nipples, 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 nipples.
It's the workshop.
Somebody made a test your mic game where you bend the old pipes down.
They were really good.
Here's one they haven't done. There you go. because of those urbexers we were hearing. Just goes